Hello friends, a very warm welcome to King in Kitchen. I am Santosh and today I am going to show you a very special recipe. The recipe is not special because of the ingredients but because of the location and the way I am going to cook it. So I am in Kerala now in my cousin brother's home and let me just pan my camera and show you the beautiful location or the scenery and the landscape. So this is the backyard of my cousin brother's home. His name is Venu Harikumar. You can see a lot of coconut trees and other trees and his small kitchen garden. And this is the front part of his house. So his house is located in between a coconut plantation. So now you would understand why I said that the location is very special. This is the monsoon season and you can see the beautiful landscape. Let's get back to the recipe now.
So I will be making this recipe using a traditional chulha and using fireworks. This recipe name is called Paisam in Malayalam or in Kerala and also known as Kheer in other parts of India. Paisam is made in lot of different ways and with lot of different things or ingredients. But today I am going to make this paisam with chana dal, jaggery and using coconut milk. So without wasting any time, let's see the recipe.
So this recipe is being made for 20 people. So you can adjust the quantity based on number of people you are making this. So for 20 people we need 10 coconuts. We have to grate them all. This is Dinu's mother who is helping us to grate the coconut. So people in Kerala use a special grater to grate the coconut because we use it day in and day out. And this helps to grate one coconut in few seconds. Then we'll put the grated coconut in a very large vessel and we need to mash them with our hand. So this helps to extract the milk very easily. After we crush it or mash it, we will put them into a very clean white cotton cloth. If you're making for a few people, you can do it with the help of mixer grinder. No need to do it the way I am showing you, but since we are making it for a lot of people, then it is quite easier than doing it in a mixer grinder. So after putting it in the cloth, we have to tighten it from both the ends and then squeeze the coconut. You can see how the milk is coming out. So it really requires a lot of effort and a good muscle strength. Squeeze it nicely so that all the milk comes out. This is the last batch we are doing. So now we have to filter the coconut milk using a strainer because while squeezing some coconut particles would have fallen inside. So that is why we are filtering it out. We need to repeat this process 3 times. So we will need milk 3 times. This is the first time, then the second time. Again we will add some warm water, 1 glass of warm water. And then again they follow the same process of crushing it or mashing it nicely and then squeezing it again. Second time the thickness of the milk will not be as much as the first time. And then we have to repeat the same process 3rd time. Third time the consistency of the milk will be very less, it will be very liquid, but the quantity will be more. This is the first milk, second milk, third milk. I'll show you how we are using this in the recipe. We place a big vessel on the chulha. So friends, this is a special vessel we are using, it's called Urli, and this is specially used for making paisam in large quantities. We'll add 1 kilo of chana dal here. We have to dry roast it for 5 minutes and keep stirring continuously. When it is nicely roasted, we will take it out in a separate vessel. Wash it nicely and then we will cook it in a pressure cooker. We need to add water. The level of water should be 1 inch above the dal. Then we have to cook it for 2 whistles. We have to cook it for 80% only and then mash it little bit. Then we will put the cooked dal again in the urli. Meantime, we have cleaned the urli. Let the dal to come to a boil. When it starts boiling, we will start adding the jaggery. So we are using 1 kilo jaggery for 1 kilo of dal for 20 people. You can adjust the quantity based on number of people. Once the jaggery melts, we will add the coconut milk. This is the third milk we are using. So keep stirring slowly while you are adding the milk. We let it boil for 10 minutes. You have to keep the flame very high and keep stirring in between. We were also very lucky to drink some fresh tender coconuts directly from the coconut tree. Let me show you the person who climbed the tree, and we were very grateful to him that because of him we were able to drink some fresh tender coconuts directly taken from the coconut tree. So this is how they climb or get down from a coconut tree, and these are the tender coconuts that we had in between. It was very hot here. Coming back to the recipe, when it thickens a little bit, we'll add the milk which we extracted the second time. Keep adding the milk slowly and also keep stirring. Here we have one guy who is adding the milk and another person stirring it. So it is my cousin brother and my elder brother who are doing it. And we let it boil for 20 minutes in medium flame. After 20 minutes, it will thicken a little bit and the color has also changed to dark brown. Now we will add the milk which we extracted the first time. It will be very thick and it is so thick that it will change the consistency and also the color of the paisam. You can see from dark brown, it has become now light brown. After we add the first milk, then we should not boil it or cook it any further. We'll put it down. The final stage is adding tadka. So adding a tadka, we'll heat ghee. We are using 5 to 6 tablespoon of ghee. Should not do any conjuicing, add in the ghee. That is what will enhance the flavor. The tadka is the enhancing the flavor. When the ghee is hot, we'll add small pieces of coconut. We'll fry it till it becomes brown in color. Now we'll add the tadka in the paisam. So finally, our chana dal paisam is ready, friends. I hope you would have enjoyed this recipe. If you indeed enjoyed this recipe, do hit on the like button and let me know your comments or feedback in the comment box. I will come back soon with another tasty, delicious and healthy recipe. Till then, bye bye.